On Monday, Prince Harry and Penguin Random House broke the news that the Duke of Sussex will be releasing a memoir in late 2022 that will share, for the very first time, the definitive account of the experiences, adventures, losses, and life lessons that have helped shape him, per the project's press release. Buckingham Palace didn't immediately respond to the news, but the palace made the rare move of declining to comment with on-the-record words rather than silence. Any clarification about the book would be a question for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, the palace said, referring to Meghan and Harry by their titles. However, Prince Harry's bombshell news that he's been writing a memoir to be published next year was met with big sighs from the royal family, a palace insider has said. A spokesperson for the Duke of Sussex has confirmed that the royal has privately spoken about the book with members of his family. The Queen had hoped time would heal family wounds and had reached out to ask the couple to attend her official birthday parade, Trooping the Colour, in June next year. The Duke of Sussex is releasing his first memoir about his life as a member of the royal family in late 2022, and many have questioned the timing of its publication. It will be 25 years in August 2022 since the death of Harry's mother, Diana, Princess of Wales, who was tragically killed in a car crash in Paris in 1997. And no doubt, he will want to pay tribute to her life and legacy in his recollection. The father of two returned to the UK earlier this month to reunite with William to unveil a statue of Princess Diana in the gardens at Kensington Palace. The memoir being written by Prince Harry will focus heavily on his mother's death, royal expert Angela Levin has claimed. Not only that, it's thought the book will also point the finger at who Harry thinks is to blame for the tragic accident. Princess Diana died in a car crash in Paris in 1997, when Harry was just 12 years old. Tentatively scheduled for publication in late 2022, the prince's memoirs could prove an explosive finale to the Queen's Platinum Jubilee year. There are grand plans for a pageant, picnics, a service and a concert to mark her record-breaking 70 years on the throne. Coupled with the anticipated sense of celebration over COVID restrictions hopefully having eased, the central weekend in June has been designed to put the monarch at the center of a moment of great national and global joy. Depending on how Prince Harry tells his story, by the end of the year she could be at the center of something very different. Meanwhile, royal source says to bring out the book in the year of the Queen's Platinum Jubilee is being seen as deeply disrespectful and clearly deliberate. To the point where his and Meghan Markle's invite to the Queen's Platinum Jubilee celebration next year, which celebrates 70 years on the throne, could be in jeopardy. However, Page Six stated that Harry's book is not meant to deliberately hurt his family, and that he just wants to tell his truth. The memoir is set to be an intimate and heartfelt account, detailing Harry's life in the public eye, from his childhood to the present day, including his military career, marrying Meghan Markle and becoming a father to Archie and Lilibet. A spokesperson said the Duke was writing the book as the prince he has become rather than the one he was born as. They added that Harry hoped the book would show people we have more in common than we think and that he was deeply grateful to share what he had learned over his life. In the UK, the book is due to be published under the label Transworld, while it will be published in the US under the Random House label and in Canada under the Random House Canada label. Prince Harry isn't the first member of the royal family to share his story. Edward, Duke of Windsor, who was Queen Elizabeth's uncle and had been coronated King Edward VIII before abdicating the throne in 1936 so he could marry American Wallis Simpson, produced a ghost-written biography titled A King's Story, The Memoirs of the Duke of Windsor in 1951. The memoir recalled his royal upbringing and schooling, leading up to falling in love with the American divorcee and ultimately giving up the position as monarch.
Thank you for watching. If you liked, feel free to leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to get new video updates. We will update the latest videos about the royal family every day. Thanks and goodbye.